Did you put your Excel formula skills to the test with this month's challenge? It's time to reveal what Excel MVP Alan Murray did to solve it.
Okay, let's walk through the different formula problems in this challenge. This is problem number one, and we have a sum function in cell B15, which looks to be correct. But the problem is with just one of those values. And the one with the problem is October, cell B11. And we can see that as we walk through the cell values, that somehow this has come across as text. And we can see that single quote before the number. If I remove that, that will turn into a numeric value, and our sum is now correct. This is problem number two, and an issue with our sum ifs function. We are trying to sum only the cells for the region of West, mentioned in cell E3, but we're getting the result of zero. And the explanation here is that somebody has got the sum range and the criteria range of our sum ifs function the wrong way around. And that is not unusual, because in the sum if function, the criteria range would come first, but with sum ifs, the sum range comes first. So if I just edit this formula, so the sum range is not going to be the names of the regions, that is the cells values, and the criteria range is not the cells values, they are the regional values. Now we don't really need to make those absolute, but let me do that because the original person had it like that. And now we get our total, 4172 for the cells from the region of West. Problem number three, and we have a VLOOKUP problem. We can see that we want to look up the continent of each of these countries, and we're looking it up on a sheet named country data. But when we look to the sheets at the bottom, there is no sheet named country data, and that is because it's been hidden. So if we begin by unhiding that sheet, just by right-clicking the tab, here is the country data sheet, and we can see that we have an empty column A, then we have the country name, the population, and then the continent in the third column of that range. Fourth column of the sheet, column D, third column of the range of country data. So the problem with that formula is that the user has accidentally referenced column 4 as the index number, and that should be 3, because their table array is going from columns B to D. So column D is actually the third column of that table array. If we run that and send it down, it now correctly returns the continents for each country. Number four, and we have a logical function problem. Somebody is using the if function with AND to try and return 10% if they are level green and amber. But AND is not really what we want here. That's the problem. That is why we have 5% for all of them. In the formula, we need the OR function. If it is green or amber, not green and amber. The confusion here being the way that the sentence is constructed, green and amber members qualify, leads people to think that the AND function is what they want. But what we want is OR. As soon as I change that to OR and send it down, those with green or Amber have 10%, the others have 5. Number 5, and we have an issue with an average function. The answer we are expecting is 76, but we are getting 70. And the problem is because John Steele is not being excluded from the results, even though he never actually sat the exam score, so we don't want him included in this average. The cell for the exam score of John Steele appears blank, but if we select that cell, there is a zero in that cell, and we can see that in the formula bar. With the average function, zero values are included in the calculation. Blank cells are not included. So if we just delete that value, the average function will then return 76 correctly. Now, how does the cell appear blank if there is a zero in there? Well, the way that was done is by clicking on the File tab, coming into Options, into the Advanced Options, and if we scroll down the options, there is one to show a zero in cells that have a zero value. And that has been unchecked. We can check that box again to ensure that a zero will be shown. There are other techniques to do that, but that is what was used to generate that issue. Number 6, and we have another lookup formula problem. The real issue this time is really that the formula being used here is the function lookup. And this I find is a common mistake. People are probably trying to use a VLOOKUP, but if they're very new to this, they end up using a function named lookup. The lookup function relies on the order of the lookup array. So in this scenario, although the names on this sheet are in order, when we look at the emp data sheet that it's using, the names are not in order. And that is causing the lookup function to break. Now, if I sorted this list in the order of the names, and then go back to that sheet, it's now working. So we could use the lookup function. It is doing its job, but the real problem is probably that the user is using the wrong function. So we could come up here, switch this to a VLOOKUP instead, to look for A2 in the emp data. Let's bring in the whole table array, to return what I believe is in the third column, and then to specify the exact match by typing 0 on the end. It worked before, it's still working now, but VLOOKUP is an improvement on the old lookup function. Number 7, and we have a SUMIF function issue. We are getting a result, and scenarios like that make solving problems so much more difficult because we are getting an answer and we may not know that the answer is wrong. Just because you get an answer, don't just run with that. Always check what you have, because this is wrong. And the reason it's wrong is in the SUMIF, the ranges you use must be equal in height. And I can see here that the criteria range is B1 to 12, and then the sum range goes from row 2 to 12. So let's edit that criteria range to start from row 2, not row 1. So it is now equal in height to that sum range, and we get the correct answer, which is 10,022. So once again, a common mistake when using functions like SUMIF. Number 8, and we have text functions to extract the client code from the references in column A. We are getting a hash value error, and the reason for that is the case of the letter. The formula we have used is looking for the character A, as that indicates the beginning of a client code, which always begins with A and then is followed by three numbers. Now we are using the find function here. So I guess there are two answers to this problem. One solution to it is that we go and fix the reference, which should have a capital A, not a lowercase a. And then the formula will work because the problem was with the data we were given, not really with the formula. However, another solution, if I go back to a lowercase a, is that instead of using the find function, because the find function is case sensitive, we could instead use the search function, which is not case sensitive, however behaves in the same way. And as I copy this down, that will work regardless of the case. Now, yes, the client code is returned in that scenario with a lowercase a, and maybe that's not correct for you, but at least we are extracting the data that we wanted. If I really needed that to be in the correct case, we could wrap the upper function around the formula we have, and that will do the final task of then converting any lowercase characters to uppercase. Number 9, and we are back to a sum function. What is going wrong here? We have the correct result, but it's been shown as a negative value, and it's a classic typo because the buttons are next to each other on a keyboard in many cases, which is that we have the minus sign after equals and before sum. If we remove that, we now have a positive value. Number 10 is an index match being used as a two-way lookup. So we actually have two matches, an index match. And we are getting the hash ref error. Why are we getting that? Now let's explore the lookup table. It's coming from the sheet data. So let's have a look. This is data. We can see that it starts in cell A1. It's four columns wide, beginning with the column ID, followed by name, and then department and salary. Let's go back and look at the formula. And what we're doing here is we're looking for the name of an individual to return the salary. And on the data sheet, the name is the second column and the salary is the fourth column. But in the index match, the array index has been given is from columns B to D. But in the second match function, the lookup array that has been given is the entire row 1. And we're trying to match the column header in C2, salary, to what is in row 1. So we have a missing reference here. We've given it the array of three columns, starting from B, but then told it to look for salary across the whole of row 1. So that match function is going to find the salary in the fourth column, but then you can't use column 4 because the index array is only three columns wide. And that is producing this error. So to fix this, we could change the lookup array of that match function to, instead of looking at the entire row 1, we can just look at the three cells that are being used in the index array. Alternatively, we could have edited the index array to start from A instead of B. Let's make that absolute and run with that. And we have the salary for Elisa. Okay, number 11 is the new X lookup function. Only for those of you on Microsoft 365, which hopefully many of you are, because that's where the action happens. We're trying to use this function for a range lookup to search for a score and return a grade. And the problem here is that number one has been used to specify the match mode. But that is not correct here. Once again, this could be a classic mistake made by people moving from VLOOKUP to XLOOKUP. Because with VLOOKUP, we can type number 1 to specify a range lookup and 0 to specify an exact match. But with XLOOKUP, let's bring up the options. The number 1 is used for the match or the next larger item. And what we want is exact match or next smaller item, just like VLOOKUP would. But with XLOOKUP, we have to use -1 for that. So there's a little bit of confusion there between VLOOKUP and XLOOKUP. VLOOKUP, you put 1 for the next smaller item. XLOOKUP is -1. A typical mistake, but an easy fix, and running that down, we now have it working. And we have a few Avengers in our ranks. Number 12, our last problem, and it's another one for Microsoft 365 subscribers, because this is a filter function, possibly the greatest function to come into Excel. Here we're using the filter function to filter the table on the left, a table called sales, and to return those for the region in cell F3 and where the total is greater than or equals 3,000. Now we've got a few problems here. First of all, we have a calc error. Now why are we getting the calc error? We are getting it because there is no region specified in cell F3. Now, if I was to select a region in cell F3, such as North, then we get a response. And the filter function successfully says that only Stephen has got a total of 3,000 or more from the region of the North. If we wanted filter to behave a little bit differently, if the region cell was empty, like it was, then we could always introduce an if error function to change that behavior and maybe return all of the sales reps that have a total of 3,000 or more. But that's something outside the scope of answering these problems. Now there is one more problem here. So this is the north, but what if we change it to the east? Ah, spill error. Another type of dynamic array formula error. And this is because somebody has very unhelpfully put a little bit of text in row 8 telling me to send this information onto Bob. Now that is in the way and our results cannot spill. We have more than 2 rows worth of results. So let me move that content out of the way, well away from my filter, and now the 3 sales reps successfully spill into the area below. So a couple of new dynamic array formula problems there. So that was the challenge, 12 different Excel formula problems. I hope you did well, and I hope you found it fun. Challenges like this are great at keeping our Excel formula skills ticking along.
So there it is. Did you get the same results? Did you use the same approach? Or did you try something different? We'd like to know. Share your take on the challenge in the comments below, or join us for more discussion in our Slack channel, link in the description. Thanks for participating, and make sure to subscribe to this channel to get an alert when the next challenge is released. We'll see you then.